Keystone species are those that play a unique and crucial role in ecosystem function. They have a disproportionately large effect on their environment relative to their abundance. Because of their key role in maintaining biodiversity, efforts to manage and protect keystone species can help stabilize the entire biological community. The term keystone species was first coined by Dr. Robert Payne in 1969. His research found that the purple sea star prevented mussels from overpopulating rocky intertidal ecosystems in the Pacific Northwest. There are five generally recognized categories of keystone species: keystone predators, modifiers, prey, mutualists, and hosts. If a keystone predator, like the gray wolf, is removed from the ecosystem, populations of their prey, such as elk, exponentially increase. This can cause a cascading effect on other plants and animals within the ecosystem. By preying on mussels that would otherwise dominate the ecosystem, the purple sea star is a keystone predator that opens up habitat for a diversity of other species. Another keystone predator is the American alligator, found in the southeastern U.S. Alligators prey on fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. The alligator is also an example of a keystone modifier, or ecosystem engineer, which creates or significantly modifies its habitat. Alligators dig depressions in the ground that fill with deeper water, providing refuge for fish and other aquatic species during the dry season. Another keystone modifier is the black-tailed prairie dog, which keeps grasslands and the Great Plains properly maintained with a diversity of plants that benefit other grazing species such as cattle and pronghorn. Prairie dog burrows aerate compacted soil and allow water to penetrate deeper into the ground. Many other species use the burrows for shelter. Prairie dogs are also an important food source for coyotes, foxes, hawks, and the endangered black-footed ferret. That brings us to the next category, keystone prey, which can cause significant fluctuations in predator densities. Pacific salmon are keystone prey, playing a vital role in Pacific Northwest ecosystems and directly benefiting 89 birds, 41 mammals, 5 reptiles, and 2 amphibians through ecosystem nutrient loading. The black-bellied salamander is another keystone prey species that provides a large amount of protein biomass for predators in certain stream ecosystems in the southeastern U.S. Keystone mutualists are those organisms that participate in mutually beneficial interactions, with hummingbirds the most notable examples. Otherwise known as link species, many hummingbirds pollinate highly specialized plants that have adapted to pollination only by these birds. The last category is the keystone host, with the quaking aspen being one example. Aspens create an open canopy that harbors diversity on the forest floor, attracting many insects not found elsewhere within the ecosystem. In addition, the red-naped sapsucker, a keystone modifier, excavates its nest in aspen trees. The abandoned nest provides shelter for many other bird species. The greater biodiversity that keystone species help maintain affords protection of water resources and soil, nutrient storage and recycling, pollution control, and better recovery from unpredictable environmental events.